As a kid, I would go to movies that would blow my mind, that would amaze me, that would take me to another world. When I decided to be a filmmaker, I wanted to give other people that feeling that I had. I wrote Avatar in 1995 based on ideas that I had when I was in college at the age of 19. I realized that the success of Avatar created a big responsibility for me. So I felt I needed to get involved and essentially become an activist on behalf of indigenous rights. I was deep in the Amazon, up the Xingu River with the Kayapo people, and I had made friends with the chief of that tribe, a man named Rope Nee. He gave me some great gifts, things that had great meaning to him. So I thought, what do I have that has that kind of value that I could give him? And I couldn't think of anything except my watch that had been with me for 20 years and had been through all my experiences. It was a Submariner, just like this one, and I wore it for 20 years. You know, everywhere I went, everything I did, 33 dives to the Titanic, making all the films that I made during that period of time. I was wearing the watch the first time I saw Titanic, for real, through the porthole of a submersible 2.5 miles down, and I was wearing the same watch in my black tie when I went up on the stage to get the Oscar for directing Titanic. And it was equally appropriate in both places. This is a watch that I bought as a replacement for the one that I gave to Rope Nee. When I look at my watch, I see all the places it's been in my mind. It's the one constant companion. People come and go. The watch is always there.